Well, hey there, boys and girls. Welcome to another brand new craft with me, Crafty Carol, right here at Cool School. Today's craft is a super awesome one. If you like awesome stuff, you came to the right place, because we're making a robot mask. So we had a request in the comments from Van Zachary asking, could you make a giant robot, please? It would be awesome. I agree, it would be awesome. We're not gonna make a giant robot today, just the mask, but you know, we'll work up to the giant robot one day, one piece at a time. So what do you need to make this craft? This one's pretty simple. You can use a lot of stuff that you find around your house. A paper bag, the cardboard roll from a paper towel roll. I got the lids of two mason jars. I got glue and I got scissors. I got duct tape and I have some extra special sparkly duct tape. And then I have some sparkly pipe cleaners. Maybe not something you got laying around the house, but you know, if you're into super awesome crafts like I am, you might have a whole closet full of pipe cleaners. I don't know. Does anybody have the time? What time is it? I don't seem to. Oh, you know, I know what time it is. It's time to start making this craft. So first thing, we got a paper bag, and I just trimmed off the bottom here because I didn't want it to be too tall. You don't want to look like Abraham Lincoln wearing a stovepipe hat as a robot. I mean, maybe you do. Maybe you're super into history. I'm just gonna start covering this in some duct tape, making it look awesome. And I'm just gonna cover every little bit of my bag. Well, okay, so we have our bag all covered in duct tape. We got the sparkly silver in front and just plain silver duct tape in the back. So let's give our robot some eyes. So we're gonna use these mason jar lids. And I got a Sharpie here. Got my jar lid down here. And I'm just gonna trace on the inside. So see, there you go. You got a black circle there. And I'm gonna do another one. Don't wanna put them too far apart because you wanna actually be able to see out of the eye holes yourself. So you don't go around with your robot mask bumping into things. You don't wanna be a clumsy robot. All right, so there we go. We got two eyes there. You can see right next to me, it's about where my eyes would be. All right, so let's cut these out. What I do when I have to cut out a circle like this, I fold it up a little, and then I give myself a snip right there, and then it's easy to cut out. So let's do it again. So you see I've got my circle here, so I'm gonna take my bag and I'm just gonna fold it right there a little bit in the middle of the circle, and then I'm just gonna give myself a little snip. Then I can just reach right in there and cut out my circle. Well, all right, there you go. It's already looking pretty cool. Kind of looks like a ghost robot right now though, so let's add these mason jar lids. It's gonna make it really pop. So you just make a ring of glue around your jar lid, and then you just smush it down right here, and then you just hold it for a while. And you just, you know, you daydream, you think about fun things like having a robot. So once your glue is dry, check it out. You got some pretty nifty robot eyes right there. I'm just gonna draw the mouth on with a Sharpie. How's that looking? That's looking like a pretty good robot mouth right there, that little rectangle. So then we're gonna cut that out, pinch it up a little bit, give it a snip. This is why I like to use a paper bag instead of a cardboard box. Cardboard can be really hard to cut. Paper bags are nice, easy to work with. Well, that's looking pretty good. All right, so now's the time to add all sorts of fun stuff to your robot mask. You can add springs or bolts, or you could even add mouse ears like Ricky Ricotta's Mighty Robot. I like those books by Dave Pilkey and Dan Santat. So let's see, what are we gonna add to our robot? I'm gonna take this and I am gonna cut a little. Let's do another one of those, about the same size. So let's cover this in our sparkly duct tape. Now I'm gonna cut little tabs there at the bottom. I can bend these out and it's easier to glue on. All right, so let's decorate our other one. Put a little glue. And you gotta just sit there and wait for it to dry. I feel like I spend half my life waiting for glue to dry. Well, I don't know about you, but I think this robot's looking pretty darn good. I'm almost expecting him to start talking to me in some kind of robot language. Some, like, a lot of beeps and boops. Like that. My goodness. Let's add a few other little things here, because I got these pipe cleaners. We could add some little springs springing off. Well, what if we gave him some eyebrows? That might be cute. We'll just take this pipe cleaner And just sort of twist it around my fingers until it's a nice little curly spring like that. I'm gonna use tape. I don't think glue is gonna work so well on these pipe cleaners. Turn around towards me. You ready for your close-up, Mr. Robot? Oh yeah? You might just have to go ahead and make a giant robot one of these days, because I am liking this. This is fun. Get a nice big giant robot costume, go out on the streets, walk around, go to the grocery store, just push in your cart, go to school in your robot costume, and ta-da! Here we go! Our very own do-it-yourself, you-made-it robot mask. Now I just gotta figure out how to put my glasses on with this thing. So you know what to do. Get down there in that comment section and tell me what craft you want to see next. Now make sure you subscribe and click right over here to watch more crafts. All right, bye.